MP for South Castries Dr. Ernest Hilaire, lamenting the two fatal shootings in four Asho Castries over the weekend, says that the government is doing what it can to curb the spate of gun violence on the island. However, he maintains that the problem requires a multi-pronged approach and will take the efforts of the wider society.
It's really painful when you hear of the gun violence, and certainly my constituency and individuals that I know, it is really, really difficult. We have a serious problem that has been, you know, developing over the last few years and is really taking its toll on us now. We tabled in the last sitting of Parliament legislation for stiffer measures against firearms, and certainly during that debate, I will share my thoughts on what I think is happening and should be done. I don't believe the solution is entirely having strong stiffer legislation. And it has been said so many times before, we need to have a national effort and a broader approach to fighting crime in the society. In the past, you've heard people say that there is crime because there are no jobs, there are no opportunities. It's a lot deeper than that. That's part of it. The availability of firearms is certainly one. The whole environment where we don't seem to be oriented towards conflict resolution and dealing with differences differently. There are just so many persons with guns. Whenever there's a conflict, the first resort is to a firearm.
The Castries South MP also reveals that discussions are also being held regarding strengthening the island's borders in hopes of mitigating the influx of illegal firearms in the country.
There are discussions taking place with partners of St. Lucia, our international friends, to see how we can muster the resources. It takes a lot of resources. The use of aircrafts, which we don't own, the use of high-powered vessels, which we're very limited in, radar facilities, and now the use of drones for one to really, you know, patrol our borders. And it's costing a lot of money. And you really have to sit down and reflect whether you're going to spend $5-6 million, you know, on capacity building to restrict, or do you spend it on, you know, intervention programs at the community level to try and reduce the tension between people and avoid some of the conflicts that we have. So it is difficult times, but we are resolute in focusing on it and trying to get a grip of it. But I must extend to all the persons who are grieved by what happened on the weekend, the innocent bystanders, the families, that we need to find different ways of resolving our differences.
Commissioner of Police Milton Desire, in response to public sentiments that the Royal St. Lucia Police Force may be too lenient on criminals, says the police act within the parameters of the law and need assistance where possible to act with the necessary urgency.
The police will do whatever they can within the means that they have. We have to act within the law, what is what we have to do. We have to take into consideration the person's rights and so on. Sometimes we may hear that it is ex-individual, but you must get the evidence. And most times, you know that the evidence comes from eyewitnesses or forensics. So sometimes, in as much as now we do not have someone arrested for a matter, but we would gather the evidence, send it for testing, and when we get if we have a positive result, then the person is brought in. There's so much that we can do. I believe crime is something for everybody, and the persons who are committing crime, they did not just decide to commit crime yesterday. They were brought up into crime, and then they continue committing crime. So this is a social issues that I think we have to address it from all angles. Most of these individuals are unemployed, and I don't think there's a way that the police can employ those persons. So they must find employment. They must have diversion activities where they will be involved. They are idle and then they commit crime.
Daisy reveals that a chronic lack of funding for the Royal St. Lucia Police Force has exacerbated its problems with fighting crime, particularly with the proper rollout of a witness protection program. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.